Hello everyone, thank you UC Berkeley students for the invitation to talk on business today. It's an honor to speak for the Management, Entrepreneurship and Technology program. My name is Bastien Beauchamp, I'm CEO of M.E.TED. You can have all the information on M.E.TED.com, download the app for free and help society make progress and save millions of lives. I've been a CEO all my life. I've never really had other jobs. Approaching my 50s, what have I learned out of university? And why a businessman from Quebec who learned English at 30-year-old will do a rap for you today? In this video, I explain my motives, my methodology, my influences, my conclusions for you, and my first song at the end. Hopefully, it will leave you with a classic message that will age well with you and follow you all your career. Please revisit the text and the lyrics at different point in lifetime. It might mean something else for you each time. If rap isn't for you, please focus on the lyrics and hopefully you'll get the message I try to transmit. So I started business at 9-year-old as a break dancer. I was dancing on Eric B music and Rakim's voice. I didn't understand a word. Didn't really care at 9-year-old. Now it's really different. I started at 9-year-old in business. After that, I had businesses in Montreal, Geneva, Switzerland, New York, San Francisco, today Berkeley, California, and Michigan as well. The first thing I learned in business school was that humans are not machines. Don't expect to program a human like you program a machine. Humans don't have direct inputs. Like, you think about four sentences, you say three, the other person hears two and understands one. We don't have necessarily the same logic, so don't expect the same output as a computer. And people don't necessarily report bugs, so listening is a really strong tool to develop. The importance of words in business, I might never emphasize enough. The words are the interface in which we transmit a message from human to human. And the most impressive work I see with words today is in rap. Actually, rap meant originally rhythm and poetry. And the parallel you can do with business are multiple. So, for instance, in rap and in business, you need to have something to say. You must create value. There's the notion of the craft, being able to craft your message to the most appropriate way. That's both in business and rap. The notion of momentum, the notion of keeping the bar at all time, the quest of excellence, the competition, and the grit. It's all in rap and in business. So today I will leave you with rap. Why? Because humans are not machines. And what I have to convey has emotions. I could not transmit that in a conference. I could not transmit that in a book or in a blog post. It came out as a rap. At 50-year-old, I can tell you that in a lifetime, we evolve, we change. And we get the notion of history and we improve. So please never stop. Push your limit. Try new things. Put yourself out of your comfort zone, like I will do today for you. Today I will sing. Tomorrow you might do something else. So show grit, show tenacity. Be inspired by Robert Paler from UC Berkeley. Robert went against all the predictions of doctors for months and months and months. He was alone walking, alone, and he succeeds. So in your lifetime, you will experience fear. Others will experience fears around you as well. What the important thing is to be able to dance on events, on good times and bad times, and never lose balance. See yourself and your life as a table with four legs. First leg is your private life. Second leg is your family life. Third leg is your friendship leg. And fourth leg is your professional life. And when you do changes in your life in one of these spheres, make sure that the other legs are stable. So you can do changes in one of the leg at a time. And I succeeded when my table was stable, and I felt when my table wasn't stable. So today, as like an attorney or an engineer, I'll explain my motivation and methodology. Like a marketing man, I will tell you that when you start a new job or enter a new industry, you better learn the culture quickly. Why? Because people are not machines. People have cohesive rationals. They have affective links, and they have emotions, which taint the whole process of decision. If you want to reach your goal, you must understand that reality as quickly as possible and be able to learn new cultures fast. When it comes to culture, my personal culture is the Beatles. I'm a product of John Lennon. I follow his artistic process. I'm a real fan. He's a real star for me in the sky. Besides that, I'm influenced in the rap today by Eric B. and Rakim. Even if I learned a 30-year-old English, I really appreciate their text today. Snoop Lion, who make me discover reggae, and after that, because of my interest for Snoop Lion, I was interested in Snoop Dogg and discovered the song Das Shiznit. And Das Shiznit is my influence for the flow of my rap today. Finally, my last influence in hip-hop is Eminem. Flabbergasted when I understand his text, I place Eminem as in the group of the best French lyricists like Brel, Brassens. He's a tremendous inspiration for business people. He goes in rap with his heart, his brain, his guts. He's full in. His dedication is extremely impressive. That's what we need in music. That's what we need in business. That's what we need in everything, actually. Other influences, MC Solar, French rap in France. I grew up with that music. MC Solar passed in our present to be in our future. Very good lyricist. Also, Loco Locas from Quebec. Other influences, my daughter for the energy, and all the reactors, the people who react to videos on YouTube and analyze songs. So I would not understand a word of rap if it wasn't for these people. People like No Life Shack. The guy has a smile, he will win you as a friend instantly. And when he analyzes a song, he's a pipeline of emotions. It's extremely impressive. Another example of video analysis is K-Ray TV. And I'll show you a clip right now of is one of his reaction to an Eminem song. So he had to stop the song because it was too much. He's a writer, so he understands what's happening. All this missing's a motorcycle. Never use all the tricks I have, so like my balls, it's in my bag. I tend to get a little testy when I'm mad, but gift to gab and pin to patch or temper tantrums into anthems. The lips to ass and kiss the cracks, spit your damnedest, it's still gonna hit the canvas. Ripping rappers, veterans to whip the snappers. Mr. Mathis is killing the shit, villainous whip with scantless syllables, rip the planet. Biblical shit's finna hit the fan. Anybody wanna go tit for tat's gonna get hit with that. Then the amygdala hippocampus is gonna trigger the ignoramus to think of the most ridiculous shit to spit, then pit it against these pitiful rappers. Insidious, these idiots, wittiest shit against me. City is MC Hammers. Get your whole squad, send a task force in. If you want it, you're about to get what you asked for then. Put your helmet on, strap your chin. You're about to get you a crash course in. Who not to start a motherfucking rap war with or to go against? Fuck what you wanna do that for, no offense. But are you retards, slow or dense? A fucking penny has more sense. Yeah, now you gotta get killed, but it's not a big deal. But every thought is so ill and so methodical. Thought I swallowed a pill, I'm starting to feel like I'm an automobile with Barnacle Bill inside the car at the wheel, inside a carnival, cause I'm plowing into every one who wrote snotty articles. And that explains why the fuck you clowns are all in my grill. Joy and pain, fortune, fame, torture, shame, choice I made.
No, no, M, give me a chance. I can't breathe, M.
So it shows that reaction videos can really add to a song. Another influence is Stevie Knight, really nice brain, very nice opinions. Knox Hill and Crypt, two rappers who analyze songs really well. I wouldn't understand English without their help. And of course, my friend, your ukulele coach on YouTube. So my first song called Fear, You will see fear a lot in business. You will see it in yourself. You will see it in others. One person can bring a whole group down because of it. So be sharp and smart with fear. It's key in business. And today I'll address it in a wrap because it's emotionally charged. Why? I work in pedestrian safety. I work with traffic fatalities on a daily basis. And it's top three cause of fatalities for children in the US. And all the technology exists in the market to solve the problem. But the process of implementing technology is so slow and people die. I feel a sense of urgency. And it came out as a rap. So my song is for people who slow progress because of their weak emotions. Thank you, UC Berkeley students, for putting me out of my comfort zone. Be considerate. Here's my first song called Fear.
For UC Berkeley students who invited me to speak on business. On a beat called Next Level by SeriouzBeats. My first song called Fear. Tu peux pas fear. When you're down, and we're all down to the ground. We spiral, inspired by all. Social downfall, global last call, fear. When you're down, and we're all down to the ground. Your inaction calls a mass reaction against the addition of your addiction to mind. Incarceration, still wondering why. Admiration isn't curation, an abomination. You sit already steadily in motion. Not intervention with infinite duration brings our institution to implosion. An invitation to a deception, an inception bar. Fixation in troubled ocean bears no notion of rational direction in all your emotional obsessional commotion. Obstination to abstention drowns realization, a compass that encompass no destination. Your super it goes with a super ego who consciously hit fishing shit, viciously hit crit. An ego ideal KO, not okay chaos created by an obnoxious, cautious, unconscious, subconscious who thinks it has wit. Your bit of conscious subconsciously loses time when you're it times you instantly quit. A tough thought, you wear an unfit destiny paired with no real mental ability to understand this. Where it contradicts your reality constantly in conflicts permanently muted with no act, it's manic. You're just a bluff, muff, fluff, wanna be tough. No new thoughts, so soft now. Not your head, not, no, not your nuts. No, you're not that hot electroshock. Call the ducks and the bucks. I'm the barman, it's your last call. At the counter, you can counter the encounter of the troll. Here comes the 911 shot, cheers. Of ducks and rims, we all but sore gull. When you swim in grim whims, we crawl and ball. Still, you stand still and stall. Like cups, your worries freeze us all. Hear the breeze, you block up for the call. Jeez. Oh, we're cold corpse, I'll rest, not fear. Tu peux pas, oui, tu peux faire mieux que tous ceux qui doutent d'eux. La tête bredouille de n'avoir ni miettes ni dépouilles, dû à ceux, tous ceux qui se la coulent douce en eux. Coulant les foules, bafouillant et souillant tous ceux qui ont le feu.
cool, j'atteste toutefois que les deux moins de cool. Déteste la houle, détexte, danse, pense pas à Tripeutex qui danse, extirpant la pensée, les tripes des tripeux. Impuissance, monsieur se permet de s'exprimer sans cesse pour faire feu. En fou furieux sur les froids, froids, vrais faux faits qu'on crée maintes fois de rendre silencieux. Essaie maintenant de faire mieux. MM.